Yo, what's up? So it's another day in the life of a truck owner. We have this little situation where one of the drivers accidentally hit something and damaged the mirror. So we out here replacing the mirror. Look how cute I am. Yep, that's me. But so we're replacing the mirror on an International ProStar. This is a 2015. And one of the things that you have to do in order to replace this mirror, and I know it looks like everything's already been taken off, but I'm just rewinding just to bring everybody back up to speed. One of the first things you have to do is you have to remove this part, right? And make sure I don't lose any screws. Now, when you're working on your mirror and you're trying to replace the front mirror, right? Because this is the front. You see the bottom mirror? That's the top mirror, which has already been taken off. When you're trying to take this off, there's a piece on the back of your mirror that looks like this. That's this piece that's on the back of your mirror, right? So first thing you do is get like a flathead screwdriver and you pop this out, right? Once you pop this out, you'll see some screws. You'll see some screws in these holes right here. Unscrew these and that'll allow you to take this off, which is the back casing to the mirror, right? So that's the back casing. We already took that off and now we're able to see the harness for the mirror. So our next step is to remove these brackets here. You got a bracket here with two screws, a bracket here with two screws, and there was one here that we already took off, and I stopped there just to show you what was going on. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this completely off, and then we're gonna install the mirror on the front side, and then we're gonna put it all back together. So thought I'd bring this to you. I'll show you the finished product halfway through, but I'm only one man, so I'm gonna get to work and then I'll bring you back up to speed once we get it installed. Let's go. All right, so we got the whole piece off. We got it all the way off. You can see it's nothing up there anymore. And now what we have to do is install this mirror on the front side of it. So we got this mirror here and we basically gotta get it bracketed to here on the front side of it. So I believe what my next step is going to be, I'm just giving you a heads up, is I'm gonna take these four screws off here, take this bracket off, and that'll allow me to fit this inside of here the way I would like to do it. It'll give me some room to actually move. So that's the next step, and I'll bring you back up to speed in a second. Let's go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so the next step was to, so you had four screws on the outside, 1, 2, 3, 4 on the outside, and then you had some screws on the inside, 1, 2, 3, 4. What we did was we initially took these four screws out thinking that we could just take it all apart and do what we needed to do, but if you take the four interior screws out, it releases the actual mechanical component that moves the mirror left and right. So when it released it, it allowed us to actually just take it and pop it in. As you can see, that's the new mirror. This is the part that we need to have installed on it. We were able to just pop it in and slide it up. Once you slide it up, it locks in. Boom, that's all one piece now. Now the step is just to go back, put this over top, and connect this arm piece, which connects to this housing, connect this to this mechanical component, and then connect this also to the housing, and it's pretty much a done deal. So we're gonna put it back together and we'll go from there. I'm sorry, I'm by myself. I wish I could have somebody hold it, but as you can see, he ain't got too many fingers, so he's not gonna hold it too well. So I'm doing it the way I can best. So I hope this is helping you guys out. So let's move on to the next step. All right, so we got the mirror back up. Now we're gonna put these clamps back on. These clamps go right here. Hold on. These clamps go around and they fasten in. So give me a second. All right, so we ran into a hiccup. I think I told y'all earlier that this needed to be on the inside, but we were wrong. So we're about to take these back out. This is supposed to be on the outside And that way, the little bar that goes up in between this, which is this bar here, it'll fit flush here. This bar here will fit flush because that's how you bracket it. And so what we did wrong was these two need to be on this side, and this entire piece here needs to be sitting out here. So we're about to fix that right now and start over. All right, so that was an easy fix. We just flipped it around. Now these holes here align with these holes. Well, this gap here, these gaps here align with this gap here, and we'll be able to bracket it to the bar that's up there and install it back on the truck. Other than that, we good to go. Oh, I think I found a dead spider. Anyway, Poppy, let's go. Vamanos, vamanos, vamanos. Okay, Titina. Okay, so we're gonna put it back on the truck. Got all eso. Vamos a puse eso primero vez. Sí, primero vez. Ese mejor.
Primero.
Oh, espérate. Titina. All right, so we're gonna bracket this bad baby up here, and as you can see, this is what I was talking about. Boom, it fits flush there and there. We had it backwards, so. Now we're gonna go ahead and finish it up and we'll show you the finished product. All right, so now we got it bracketed back up. You can see the brackets are back on. Make sure when you're doing it, make sure these little pieces, they kind of just hang here. Make sure you put these in first and kind of line it up. You got one at the bottom and then you got one at the top right here. Make sure you kind of line that up first before you put these brackets on right here. Now that we have that in, all we have to do is secure this connection here. Zip tie this here because for some reason this isn't where it needs to be, so we're going to zip tie that. And then this last little wire here actually plugs into the back of this here. As you can see, it plugs in there, and then we just need to squeeze that into there. So we're going to secure this connection here real quick. Put, I think we got three screws we need to put in here, and that'll tie in right along this strip here, 1, 2, and 3. That'll secure there. And we're gonna bring this out through here, connect it to that light, and it's a done deal. Hope this video helped you. If it did, and you wanna see more, anytime I have any issues, I'm gonna make more videos. Make sure you like and subscribe. Leave me a comment, let me know what you think. Until next time, I'll let your boys North Star Transport. All right, y'all, it's a done deal. We got the mirror completely back on and installed. Before, we had these little straps right here holding it up because I didn't get it installed and we had to hit the road. We didn't have time to kind of figure it out, but we got to figure it out. You can see the plate is back on it completely, and it's on. Let's double check and see if it's working and we'll go from here. It's a done deal. Let's see. Let's get in. All right, we inside the big boy. All right, it's on. Here we go. Turn it on. Boom. Switch the mirror to that side and... Oh yeah, she moving. We back in business, baby. We back in business, baby. Up and down, moving perfectly. We good to go. All right, that's it. It's the boy King of Raleigh with North Star Transport and Billionaire Barbershop. Just another little, just a quick little tutorial for you. Hope you guys like it. Make sure you like and subscribe. And as always, holla at your boy.